Okay, guys, here we are. I'm just gonna lower my planter here. Adjust the So I have 11 minutes to plant this field until they start pulling a trigger on grain. You see that they're being retarded over there. These guys are terrible. They're just cutting across the fields. It's amazing how much time it actually takes. I mean, our last harvest, we had like 24 hours on this tractor. Now we have basically 53 hours. So it's like the amount of time it takes to do all the tillage and stuff like that is incredible. So, really shouldn't be planting and burning, but who really cares? We have stuff to do. At the same price. Yeah. Yeah, more moisture. So I have the loan interval sent to 365 days, which is, I don't know what that comes out to, like 12 seasons, essentially, it would take us to pay off our loans, which would be like 12 years. So we should have more than enough time to pay off all of our loan, even with the huge chunk of change it takes to lease our land. It's like $250,000 just in land rentals. And then you're looking at probably 100 plus. Well, we already spent like 30, 70. You're probably looking at 150,000 in seed and machinery rental and herbicides. So it's right around 400,000 this season that we put into our crop. So. It's 400,000 into the ground before we get anything out of it. Now, granted, we'll probably end up around 1 million or like 1.2, 1.5 mil in revenue. So, slowly but surely, we'll be tackling our debt and trading in some equipment and, you know, just trying to make a living. But have the yield set up correctly. I have the land fees set up to be right around 200 an acre is what it costs us to rent a season, which I think is a pretty representative price of a lot of the land where I'm from. So $200 per acre per season, you're looking at loan interest around 6% annual interest with 10-year, like 12-year, 10-year note. Our corn crop is about $4.50 a bushel. Beans, like $10 a bushel. Bean, probably not sure. Yields of corn's like 260. Beans around 70, 75. Wheat's like 100. Barley's like 90. Canola is, I forget what canola. Nice thing about unloading all this corn is it's going to skyrocket our bean price. Thank you. 88.9 miles an hour. 91.7. Too bad you can't make payments on equipment. That'd be cool. Waiting for a canola grid demand. That would put us around like 70,000. 70,000 a truckload. I think we're around like 24,000 a truck right now. Maybe. I love that John Deere CCSC metering exact emerge. This isn't an exact emerge, I don't think. Planting in the rain. Mike's loading up, Jake's selling. I'm finishing up planting. Probably two more passes here and call it a day. Call it a end of spring. And then we get our Patriots all prepped and ready to spray some more herb and some more nutrients when needed. And definitely need to spray this field in 14 with herb A, but perhaps later. Maybe spray it on some lime. We were getting so many demands for like sand and wheat like windrow, like baled wheat. And we weren't getting anything for beans or corn, and now we were getting them. Go ahead, return it. How are we doing? We're at... Oh, they still got a ways to go. Ah, they pretty much unloaded 60% of our corn in 12 minutes, so... Not the biggest field in the world, but this thing is gonna just make us money. These cornfields over here are just gonna make us money. So this big field, this field 25 here, that's all soybeans. So it's gonna be another money maker. This big field here of 14, that's all corn as well. So it's gonna be another big cornfield. 26 here on the left, 27, 28. It's all barley. Field across the road, there's beans. So this is all barley right here that we're looking at. That's big bean field. Bean field across the road. Then all these fields up here are barley as well. So no canola this year. No wheat. No oats. Never really seen any demands for oats or wheat. Pretty much, or really canola. I mean, but. We planted it. We're just holding on to it, hopeful for a good price on canola one of these days. There's always a great demand for corn and beans. It seems like every other week there's a demand for one of them. So, those barley, these are going to be really. We're going to be doing a lot of draper work. So, I'd say 80% of our land is all draper work. So. Between beans and barley, we planted 17 as corn, so I mean that's a pretty big field. We have 24, 14, 17, 6 and 7, 11. So we have quite a bit of corn planted. If we do our soil management right, corn is actually pretty profitable just because the amount of grain we pull out of the fields. The issue is can we get it trucked in to the sell point in time, you know. If I were to be on a third truck, we would definitely be able to haul a lot more grain, but between two guys hauling grain to Conagra, it's... I think me and Jake did 1.4 million liters an hour by ourselves, so you're looking at probably 2.1, maybe 2.2, if not more, because I think we had time left over as well. So this is going to be a big fun field to do draper work on. Might have to invest in another grain sell point or another grain elevator complex. So. Wow, they're not even using the roads, they're just driving like in the grass. Like, what's the point of even buying, putting the hours to build roads if people don't even do them? See what I mean? I don't get it. So, well, there's Jake. We have this is looking at. Corn. Save this. So we're at 'Cause I got a little bit slicker rig than they do. Courtesy of LMB Farmer. There's our alfalfa ready to cut. Big field of corn coming up. Soybeans. In line. Gotta love that corn texture. It looks so real. The other big beef farm. Wonder how much we're going to get from this load. Doesn't do its little green. There's Mike. There goes Mike. I'm not really a fan of sleepers. I like day cabs myself, but looking mighty fine over here. So yeah, we're kind of overkill with our trucking department, but overkill's overrated, as they say. Why is this not? So all we have left is canola. This is glitching bad. Small bin. there's the train. We're just gonna go right through it. It's like magic. Pretty much done with beans. The train, you can see the grain complex, you can see some old fields. I mean, big newer beef farm. guys. Thanks for watching, guys.